Hello, dear student. Once again, I'm going to talk about the part of speeches or the part of speech. In the previous video, I have discussed the first one, noun. What is noun? Its type and its examples. So in this video, I'm going to focus on the very important part of speech that plays a very vital role in our writing, in our, you know, writing practices, that is pronoun. So what is pronoun today? You know, pronoun is a word that replaces, or it is an alternative for noun or noun phrase. Without pronoun, you cannot write effectively. If there is no pronoun in your writing, it means that the same subject will repeat in this story in your writing. For example, Sita went to the store, buy a shirt. Sita picked a blue shirt and go to the marriage jacket, right? Likewise, the same subject or the same Gita is repeated in the same sentence. So instead of that, we can use pronoun. Okay, so what is pronoun? Pronoun is an alternative word, you can say. It is an alternative alternative for noun or noun phrase in sentence. So a noun may take place of noun of a person, place or thing, right? So there are seven pronouns, as everyone knows that I, we, you, he, she, it, they. These are the very popular pronoun in our English language. So how it works, let's see. So this, look at the sentence. In Spain, apple are amazing, right? So apple is a noun, or apples is a plural noun. So in this next sentence, or in the next sentence, you can say, they look like a cartoon apple. Okay, so this apple replaces with the word, with the pronoun they. So they look like a cartoon apple. I cannot say apple look like a cartoon apple. Okay, so repetition of the same subject, same noun is stopped here, and we can use another alternative word for our sentence. Okay, another, you can say, where noun phrase is replaced. Okay, so the Spanish apple from Madrid is amazing. Now see, there is a phrase, noun phrase. This Spanish apple from Madrid. So that phrase is replaces with the one noun, that is, it look like a cartoon apple. Okay. So this is how that pronoun works in our language. Okay. So let us see and try to understand the types of pronoun. As I already said, popularly or commonly, every student or everyone knows that there are only seven pronouns. I, we, he, she, you, I, we, he, she, you, they. Okay. But when we go into the detail, we will find that there are some personal pronouns, there are some reflexive pronouns, there are some possessive pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, indefinite pronoun, relative pronoun, and intensive pronoun. So in this video, I'm going to explain you all in detail. Okay. So what is personal pronoun? Let's see. In personal pronoun, we always, try to understand what is, let me tell you what is a personal pronoun. So in our sentences, a personal pronoun is a pronoun that is related mainly to a particular person. Okay, so personal pronoun are not limited to people and can also refer to animal and object. Now see, there are two types of personal pronoun. One is subject pronoun and the another one is object pronoun. So as I already said that I, we, you, he, she, it, we, they, these are subject pronoun because it comes in the very beginning in the sentence. And the object pronoun that comes in the middle, in the last, or in the end of the sentence, that is me, you, him, her, it, us, you, by, sorry, you and them, right? So for example, I have green eyes. Okay, I is a personal pronoun, and I have, actually, you can say, in my hand, I have three, or I have green eyes, I have green apples. They are coming to my house. Third person pronoun, you can say. Or the you can say in the next picture, that subject pronoun, first, second, and the third singular pronoun is I, you, he, she, it. And when you go and use the object pronoun, it will turn into, or it will change into I into me, you into you, and him, her, it. So when you talk about the plural pronoun, the first person, we, change, will change into us, you remain same, and they will turn into them. Okay, so you can use various example. For example, I like to watch TV, but he does not. Okay, he studied hard to pass the exam. She stuck him, or she struck him on the nose. These are the various examples of personal pronoun. Come to the reflexive pronoun. What is reflexive pronoun? Reflexive pronoun, you know, will end, you know, you can see the example. The reflexive pronoun will end in dash self or selves. Now it is very clear. There are so many words like myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, and themselves. So all these words, you know, are the words that has the suffix, you can say self or selves. So you can use various words in reference to another person. Okay, it is always used to you know, to refer another person. How? He takes care of himself. Okay, now see, she can do it by herself, right? You can travel by yourself. So at the end of that sentence, I have used the reflexive pronoun. So that reflexive pronoun refers to the subject or the noun, the first noun, that he, she, you, she, Tom, you can say. So this is how you can understand the reflexive pronoun. Then come to the another, that is possessive pronoun. What is possessive pronoun? We use possessive pronoun to refer to a specific person, people, or things. Okay. It means we always show the ownership that indicates the possession. For example, this is my pen. Okay. This is your pen. This is mine pen. These are the various possessive pronoun. For example, you can see the examples are already on your screen to understand the use in a sentence. This is my laptop. It's mine, you can say. It's not yours. It's his book. Okay, this ship is theirs, not ours. So it shows the possession. Okay, the ownership or the belonging to a person or to any place, you can see, right? So you can see the list of the progressive pronoun like mine, yours, his, hers, ours, yours, theirs. Okay, come to the another one, the demonstrative pronoun. Okay, demonstrative pronouns, there are some pronoun that indicates something, that always used to indicate some things. For example, that hat, this hat. So these demonstrative pronouns are that, this, these, and those. So there are four demonstrative pronouns. And these demonstrative pronouns we can use in such a way. For example, this is my chair. Okay. That is Richard's house. These are her paints. Those are migrating birds. Right? So here, in while talking about the singular thing, this is my pen. It means that there is only one pen and this that is belong to me. But when there are many things, for example, many books, so these books belong to Ram or Sham, you can say. And all these are very close to me. Okay. But when that things are placed there means far away. There is a distance in between. So that is why you can say, you can refer to these or that things. Likewise, those hats. Okay. That hat. Likewise, you can use the examples. For example, if I tell you again, this is an enormous field. Can you see that? These are delicious cookies. Okay. So this is how, you know, easily we can understand with the help of various examples. Okay. Come to the indefinite pronoun. Dear student, these indefinite pronoun use to talk about something which is not specific, which is not confirmed, which is not particular. So it is unknown, you can say, right? So the indefinite pronouns are another, anybody, anyone, anything, each, either, enough, everybody, everyone, everything. That is not specific, or it is not specified in that sentence, right? For example, if I say, nobody is going to the party, right? So here, nobody is referred to the indefinite pronoun. So indefinite. For example, I like both of these photos. I like both of these photos. These photos, not particular one or not specific one, right? So these indefinite pronouns refers to non-specific things or objects or any places, you can say. And indefinite pronouns can also functions as other parts of speech too, depending on the context, right? So when you talk about the singular noun or pronoun, you can use another, either, less, anybody, enough, little, anything, much, neither, each, everything, something, one, other, nothing, etc. And the plural pronouns are both few, fewer, many, other, and several, right? You can also use indefinite pronoun to refer the singular and the plural words also. For example, all, any, more, most, none, such, some, right? So this is how you can understand the indefinite pronoun. Now the next one is relative pronoun. Relative pronoun is always used or can be used as a way of giving additional information within a sentence, right? We can add information, or we can add, you know, while understanding the clause, indefinite or main clause or subordinate clause, you can use these words. For example, woman means there is a woman who called yesterday, wants to buy the house, right? For example, there is one sentence. Now there were driving by the houses which Andy had described, right? So additional information, for example, in the third sentence, you can see she is an artist. Okay. She is an artist whose work is really admired, right? So these words are easily understood by these examples. So we can add information within a sentence, right? So these pronouns are who, whom, which, whose, and that. Okay. Come to the intensive pronoun. what is intensive pronoun? So intensive pronoun is used as a reference to another pronoun or noun in the same sentence as a way of emphasizing is it, right? For example, maybe in the reflexive pronoun, we have studied this type of pronoun. Now see the example. So Sarah can open it herself, right? So it is, the emphasis is given on the Sarah, right? By using the intensive pronoun, that is herself. Another example is, we can raise the fund ourselves, right? We can raise the fund ourselves. So we is emphasized, we is focused with the help of this intensive pronoun ourself. Okay, so these are very important things, my dear student. There are other pronouns also that I have not covered in this presentation. For example, interrogative pronouns, reciprocal pronouns, right? And many more, right? So here, if you go and try to understand the personal pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, reflexive pronoun, intensive pronoun, possessive pronoun, relative pronoun, indefinite pronoun, or interrogative pronoun, you must understand very seriously, so that you can write very effectively, you can write perfectly, or you will never make mistake, right? I hope, my dear student, you learn the pronoun and the types and with its example. And thanks for watching this video. If you like, you must like my video and subscribe my channel so that you can get the latest notification of newly uploaded video. So thank you.